Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Doc at Padama. Ngayon pag-usapan natin yung tinatawag nating culminating activity sa pagsusulat ng inyong research. Walang iba kundi yung tinatawag ninyong research defense. So whether you're in the basic education level, tertiary level sa college, or even in the graduate school level, nagtatake ng master's or doctorate degree ninyo, you would be able to benefit from this discussion and it will greatly help you be more effective sa pagde-defend ng inyong research. So this is one of our Taglish version ng ating video and nakalagay dyan no problem. Kaya sabi nga natin kanina, hopefully this would lighten the burden ng pagde-defend nyo sa inyong research. So I'm pretty sure that if you go through this checklist, makakatulong sa inyo ito sa pagde-defend ninyo. These are some of the outline na pag-uusapan natin. Bibigyan natin ng discussion yung bawat point na yan, yung 11 points na yan. At ito ay hahatiin natin sa tatlong bahagi. Before the defense, during the defense, and after the defense. And ano ang ibig sabihin nitong mga parts na ito. Before we start, please help my YouTube channel, Doc Ed Padama, by clicking the subscribe button and click the notification bell to alert you when a new video has been uploaded just like this one. So, let's start. So, makikita niyo dyan, may tatlong bahagi yan. Simulan na natin dun sa una. So, before the defense, ang sabi natin dito kanina ay read, read, read. Anong ibig natin sabihin kapag read, read, read? At anong babasahin? Ito yung tinatawag nating manuscript. When we use the term manuscript, this refers to a document and this document refers to your research paper. So, palagi niyong isipin kapag pinasubmit kayo ng manuscript, pinaprint yung manuscript sa inyo, pina-upload yung manuscript, again, this refers to your research paper. So, what do you need? Why do you need to read? Why do you need to read? Na-establish na natin ano ang kailangan nyong basahin. Ang tanong ngayon, bakit nyo kailangan basahin yung manuscript ninyo o yung research paper ninyo? Number one is to retain the information. To help you retain the information, you need to go through. Not once, not twice, but at least three times. Go through different parts of your research. You can do it sequentially. Okay, you can do it by chapter, sequentially from chapters 1, chapter 1 by chapter, or you can do it in random. Okay, how do you read in random? So kapag master na ninyo yung isang chapter, halimbawa chapter 1, lahat ng content ng chapter 1, kabisado ninyo na. Lahat ng pwedeng itanong sa chapter 1, kabisado ninyo na. But you are having problem with chapter 2. So you go directly to that particular chapter that you need to focus into and basahin nyo ng basahin. So example, if your weakness is chapter 2, anong kinalaman nitong mga citations, sources, references sa research ninyo? You read, what are these citations? What is the content of these citations? Okay, what is the context of these citations? Bakit ba nila sinabi ito? Ano ang relationship nitong mga citations na ginamit ninyo doon sa inyong research? So, you do not just read these citations by content. You also need to establish the context. The context is the situation, surrounding the research. So ano ba yung nangyayari nung panahon na yon? Bakit nila nasabi ito? Okay? At bakit ito yung ano yung relevance? Establish the relevance of these citations to the research that you are conducting. Okay? The next one is organize. You read because you need to organize your thoughts, the sequence of your thoughts. So halimbawa, ang tanong sa inyo is, how did you arrive? Where did you get these questions from your SOP? Specifically, the specific problems in your research. So, organize ninyo. When you answer, since nabasa na ninyo and explain sa inyo, tinanong ninyo, na-verify ninyo, ma'am, sir, ito pong mga specific questions namin are there to help answer the objective and the title of our research. Oh, di ba ganon? So, ang specific problems ninyo nandyan at you're assuring the panel that all of this are in line in order to answer the objective and the goal of your research. So, yun yung line of thought na kailangan organized kapag sumasagot kayo sa defense ninyo. At magagawa nyo lang ito kung binasa ninyo yung manuscript ninyo. Okay. Another reason why you need to read is to understand the relevance, the connection of every part of your research hanggang doon sa objective and output ng inyong research, from the problem to the solution. Okay, and this will be reinforced. Mangyayari lang ito kung babasahin ninyo. I know sometimes or most of the times there are parts of your research that you cannot understand even if you read it 3 times already. Pero I am telling you that aside from reading, if you do further research doon sa part na yon, it would enlighten you. And again, babalik tayo, this will only happen if you read and read further beyond your manuscript, if you still have time. Okay, the next one is check and double check. What are you going to check and double check? Again, what are you going to check and double check? Double check your presentation. Is everything there? Okay, for every institution, there are different parts that are required for a researcher to be presented or to be included doon sa PowerPoint presentation niya. So how do you check this? Presentation in terms of your PowerPoint presentation, especially sa panahon natin ngayon na online pa rin tayo. Ulitin natin, for every institution, for every school, iba-iba yung requirement nila kung ano yung ilalagay sa PowerPoint presentation. But I have an idea. I have presented a video of this in my YouTube channel, yung mga dapat ilagay sa PowerPoint presentation during defense, that's the title, and you can use that as a guide. And then if there are things that your advisor or teacher would like to include, minimal na lang ang magiging inclusions or yung lack ng PowerPoint presentation ninyo. So you initiate, kayo na yung magkusa. Pero my advice is, you do not put everything in the PowerPoint presentation. Even if that's the introduction, you do not copy the whole introduction. So there is a proper way of doing that. And again, if you want, you can refer to my video in my YouTube channel. Okay, now the next one is double check your manuscript. Oops, double check your manuscript in terms of typographical errors. Typographical errors are normal, pero yung masyadong madaming and frequent, masyado na madalas na typographical error will not be good for your defense. So it's okay to have typo errors. Kahit kami, nagkakaroon ng typo errors from time to time. But again, too much or yung frequent typographical errors would not help you during your defense. So again, it is advisable that you double check your manuscript. When you read, may encounter nyo yung typo na yan. Okay, and then you can readily, correct that even before the defense. Okay, the next one is to simulate. How do you simulate? You imagine the situation. You're already in the defense. So we're talking about before the defense. Before the defense, you simulate the defense. Simulate the defense in terms of ano yung mga possible questions na pwedeng itanong doon sa defense. And try to answer that. Okay? Answer, saan nyo makikita yung sagot? Try to ask yourself during that simulation, where will I find the answer to this question? Example, you were asked, what is the rationale of your study? Where will you find rationale of the study? Rationale of the study can be found in chapter 1. So, where in chapter 1? Chapter 1, in the introduction, in the last paragraph of the intro, you're going to find the rationale of the study. Supposed to be, dapat may rationale of the study on that part of your research. And then you can readily use that. It's either you you already have read that, nabasa nyo na, pwede nyo na lang ibigay yung idea, or if you cannot recall, you can read from that part of your research. That is the importance of your manuscript. You don't need to memorize. You need to understand the logic of your research. Yung sequence logic, saan nyo makikita yung sagot kapag ito ang itinanong. Okay? And then, when you are asked to explain, and then you are asked to discuss, so you also practice that in the simulation. How would you present your idea? How would you expound your idea? So papasok na dito yung paggamit yun ng language, yung technical niya sa grammar. So may mga questions and debate regarding the use of yung language. If required ba mag-English, pwede ba mag-Taglish? The main advice that I give them is this. Make sure you are familiar with the idea. Focus on the idea, not the language. Actually, you really need language in order to communicate your idea. Kailangan nyo talaga, marunong kayo gumamit ng lengguahe. Kung ano yung nire-require sa inyo, English or Tagalog, depende sa research na dinidefend niyo. Pero, kung hindi talaga kayo magaling, hindi nyo master yung English, at least yung idea, you can get that across even if your language is not that good or below average. If you really try your best to find words, simple words, yung nakalagay dyan, simple words, in order to express your idea, it will be appreciated by the panel. So, importante, alam ninyo kung ano yung gusto nyong sabihin. The idea. Okay? When you are communicating your answer. Okay, the next one is practice. In relation to simulation, what do you need to practice? Practice answering. Practice communicating. Practice language or language use. Use of the language that you are required to implement during the defense. Okay? So, if it is English, practice speaking in English. Okay? Before the defense. So, you don't necessarily need to face a mirror. Kausapin nyo lang yung sarili ninyo, or you can even do it in your mind. If this is the question, how are you going to answer? You can also take notes, cue cards, footnotes. Pwede nyong sulatan yung manuscript ninyo. Hindi bawal yon. Okay? Ang bawal is yung dire-diretso na kayong nagbabasa. Doon kayo pinipigilan. Doon kayo pinapahinto. Especially if you do not understand what you are reading. Because you're reading something that is not relevant, hindi naman connected doon sa tinanong. Di ba? Okay? As much as possible, the panel will listen to what you are reading. Pero kapag nagbabasa na kayo ng hindi naman connected sa tinatanong, that's the time na pahihintuin na kayo ng panel. Okay? That is why it is important whatever you throw or give or you answer the panel should be relevant doon sa tanong. So, importanteng nakikinig kayo kung ano yung tanong. So, practice answering. Practice answering as if you are already in the defense. And the last one, bago mag-defend, is organize your thoughts. Organize your thoughts requires you to listen carefully. So, when you listen to the question, it puts you on the right track. Whatever is required, in terms of the question, ito lang yung tanong, ano ba yung hinihintay nilang sagot, hindi mo na ibigay, dahil you were distracted by so many information or information overload because of beating around the bush. You failed to give a direct answer. So when you listen, you're on the right track, and you can give the proper response to the question na ibinibigay sa inyo o itinatanong sa inyo ng panel ninyo. So makinig kayong mabuti. Kapag kayo tinanong na ng how and why, that's the time that you can explain. You can expound, give examples, citations, references. Pero kapag hindi, tinanong lang kayo ng ng logical question, yung answerable by yes or no or even by figures, values, tinanong, sino ang population ninyo, ilan ang population, sino is ano, diba, logical. So, sino, students, anong year level, sabihin nyo kung anong year level. And then, ilan sila? Sabihin nyo yung value kung ilan. Kapag tinanong, bakit sila ang ginamit ninyo? Then, that's the time you explain. So, nakita ninyo yung classifications ng questions. Logical and critical. Logical is yung answerable by discrete answers. Ibig sabihin, specific answers. Kapag critical, you need to explain the reason behind that. So, ito yung mga iba't ibang klase ng tanong na kailangan aware kayo at familiar kayo so that you can organize your answers. That will fall under the organization of thoughts. And ito ay nagagawa. This can be attained by, again, you practice. Okay. So, everything is related. During the defense, let's start naman dyan. During the defense, you practice breathing. Breathing can help you think. Can not only help you relax, but also help you to think. You know why? I know all of you are familiar that our brain needs oxygen. Diba? Our brain needs oxygen for it to function efficiently and effectively. So, as simple as breathing will make a difference in your defense. So, example, during the defense, you're too excited in giving the answer kasi alam ninyo kung ano yung sagot. Try to observe, dire-diretso siyang magsalita to the point that hindi na siya humihinga. Yung matagal siya bago mag-inhale. Hindi ba? Puro exhale kasi puro salita siya. That is going to hamper your ability to answer. 'Di ba? Kasi nauubusan na ng oxygen yung brain niyo dahil excited kayong sumagot, dire-diretso yung salita niyo, hindi kayo nakakapag-inhale and nawawala ng air or oxygen yung brain niyo. That will lead to ano yung palaging reason, na may mental block, nakakalimutan, hindi maalala at kung ano na pa. Relax, you breathe so that you can maximize the efficiency of your brain sa pagsagot ninyo. Okay? So maraming klase ng breathing. Try to find out, identify anong klase ng breathing na mag-work para sa inyo. Merong iba, isang deep breath lang. Hihinga lang ng malalim. Okay na. Merong iba, multiple short breaths. Okay? Yung multiple burst ng breath sa kanila para yun ang ano sa kanila eh, bagay sa kanila. So, hanapin niyo alin ba doon ang mag-work para sa inyo. So, that's number one during the defense. Number two, focus on the question at hand. Remember? So, ito, during the defense na. Kung ano lang yung tanong, yun lang yung sagot. Kanina, pinapractice ninyo. Ngayon, i-implement na ninyo. Focus, listen, what question is being asked, and then yun lang yung sagutin ninyo. Kapag kayo ay pina-explain, eto na yon. Tinanong kung how, why, discuss, expound. That's the only time that you explain your answer. So this one would be logical. And then this one would already be critical. So pag sinabi nating logical, answerable by yes or no, facts, figures, values, pag sinabi nating critical, kailangan nyo na i-discuss, explain, irrationalize. And everything, all of this, should be located in your manuscript. Again, babalik tayo dun sa unang advice natin, read, read, read. The next one is courtesy and respect. Courtesy and respect to whom? The panel, your advisor, guests. Kasi minsan merong mga guest panelists outside of your school. Try to practice courtesy and respect. Okay? One advice, during the defense, aggressiveness will not help you. aggressiveness will not help you during the defense. Overconfidence leads to aggressiveness. Overconfidence leads to aggressiveness. Yung masyado kang confident sa sinasabi mo na ayaw mo nang tumanggap ng suggestion, ng recommendation, again, it will not help you during the defense. Okay? The reason why the panels or panelists are there are the following. Pupunta na dun sa susunod, yung open-mindedness. Okay? Keep an open mind regarding recommendations. The panel are there to improve your work, to organize your work, or to help you. Hindi kalaban yung panel. Do not view them as an antagonist or villain. They are there to help you improve and organize your research. Okay? Because of the experiences and qualifications that they have, and sila mismo nakagawa na ng mga research yan. Okay? So the next one is take note. Take note. I know this is very, very, very difficult, not impossible, to take note during the defense. But this is what you can do. Itong pwede nyong gawin. Pwede kayong mag-ask ng help since this is done online from one of your, kung sino yung kasama nyo sa bahay, to take note of the, what are you going to take note? The suggestions of the panelists, and then specifically, saang chapter yung suggestion nila, anong page number, at ano yung kailangan i-revise o suggestion nila. And then make sure you implement what has been suggested because there are schools na hindi kayo i-clear, hindi kayo ipapasa, hindi kayo bibigyan ng grade kapag hindi na-implement yung mga suggestions. Now, during face-to-face, ang nagte-take down nitong suggestion na ito is the advisor. Especially in the college level and the graduate school. So usually sa basic education, sa high school, junior and senior, usually hindi naman na nila tinitake. So kung kayo lang ang nandon at kayo ay may mga kasama, may ka-group, make sure you assign one of your group mates to take notes. Now we're almost at the last part after the defense. Attitude of gratitude. This is simply put as this one. So, acknowledge the presence of your panelists. Research their names. Okay? Ano yung pangalan nila? And then after that, you acknowledge their help. So, ganun lang. So, kung natapos na yung defense ninyo, I would like to thank our panelists, Dr. Ganito, name and surname, the Dean Ganito, name and surname, VP Ganito, Vice President Ganito, name and surname, for the help that you have extended during my defense. Thank you very much, everyone. And I really appreciate all of the recommendations and suggestions that were given to improve my research paper. Thank you. And God bless. O, ganun, di ba? Parang closing speech mo. You express your attitude by acknowledging the presence of your panel and the help that they have extended. So basically, this is what you need to recall, remember, and to take note kapag kayo ay nagde-defend. So napakarami po nating video na ginawa para makatulong sa defense ninyo. And some of them are on the left side of your screen right now. These are my suggested videos. And at the bottom right side of your screen, makikita nyo yung icon ng mukha ko. When you click that, you will be diverted to the subscription button of my YouTube channel. So please do click that and click the notification bell para ma-alert kayo kapag meron na tayong bagong video ulit na napapanahon at kailangan ninyo sa pagsusulat nyo ng research. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat. Stay safe, everyone, and God bless. See you on the next video. Bye!